السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear students, today I will give lecture about jaundice and liver function test. First, I will define jaundice. Jaundice refers to the yellow appearance of the skin, sclera and mucous membrane resulting from a increased bilirubin concentration in the body fluid. It is usually clinically detectable when the plasma bilirubin exceeds 3 mg per deciliter or 50 mmol per liter. Normal serum bilirubin is 0.2 to 1.2 mg per deciliter or 2 to 21 millimicromole per liter. What is the latent jaundice? It is always asked in the exam. What is latent jaundice? Clinically, there is no jaundice. Clinically, there is no jaundice, but serum bilirubin is more than normal, but below 3 mg per deciliter. Clinically, it is not exposed, but in calculation, it is more than normal level. When more than normal level, the bilirubin, but clinically not exposed, then it is called latent jaundice. Now what bilirubin metabolism? You know, a RBC lifespan is 120 days. After 120 days life, the RBC automatically broken and the hemoglobin comes out. You know hemoglobin, two part, heme and globin. Globin go to the protein pool and amino acid come out from it. Heme has two part, iron and protoporphyrin. Iron is stored as ferritin. Then porphyrin, protoporphyrin converts into bilirubin, bilirubin converts into bilirubin. Bilirubin form a complex with albumin and taken up by liver. In liver, bilirubin is conjugated with glucuronic acid and forms bilirubin glucuronide. This bilirubin glucuronide excreted in the bile duct. From bile duct, it exceeds intestine, reduced by bacterial flora of colon as urobilinogen. 10 to 20% urobilinogen reabsorbed by portal vein. Conjugated bilirubin is water soluble, so it is permeable to glomerulus membrane and appear in urine. Here I am showing a flow chart. Here you say, see the red blood cell broken into heme and globin. Globin go to protein pool, then heme, it has two part, protoporphyrin and iron. Iron is stored as ferritin, then protoporphyrin converted to bilirubin. Bilirubin then unconjugated bilirubin. It is added by albumin. Then it is taken up by liver and joined with glucuronic acid. By joining glucuronic acid, it became conjugated bilirubin. This conjugated bilirubin occurs in bile duct. From bile duct, it goes to the intestine. This conjugated bilirubin is reduced by bacterial flora. Then it is converted to urobilinogen. 10 to 20% of bilirubin comes into liver by portal vein. A small part mix with systemic circulation and go to kidney and pass as urine. And maximum part passes through stool by forming starcobilinogen. That is all about the bilirubin metabolism. Now our difference between unconjugated and conjugated bilirubin. Normal serum level, unconjugated more or conjugated bilirubin less. What are solubility? Unconjugated bilirubin is not water soluble, but conjugated bilirubin is water soluble. Affinity to lipid. Unconjugated bilirubin has affinity for lipid, but conjugated bilirubin no affinity for lipid. Serum albumin binding. Unconjugated binds with serum albumin, but conjugated bilirubin binds very low with albumin. Van der Waals reaction indirectly positive in unconjugated bilirubin, but directly positive with conjugated bilirubin. Renal excretion absent for unconjugated, as it is not water soluble, but present for conjugate. Affinity to brain tissue, it is present for unconjugated because it is lipid soluble, so it has affinity for brain tissue. But conjugate bilirubin has no affinity for brain tissue. Pathophysiological classification of jaundice. Predominantly unconjugated hyperbilirubinemia. Predominantly unconjugated hyperbilirubinemia and predominantly conjugated hyperbilirubinemia. This two part of pathophysiological classification of jaundice. So number one, predominantly unconjugated hyperbilirubinemia. It can occur by three causes. Number A, due to excess production of bilirubin. Excess production of bilirubin occurs due to hemolytic anemia, ineffective erythropoiesis, that means thalassemia. Number B, decreased uptake due to number one, prolonged starvation and sepsis. Number two, Gilbert syndrome. Pathological classification of jaundice. Predominantly unconjugated hyperbilirubinemia. Number C, impaired bilirubin conjugation. It has three causes. Number one, hereditary disorder, that is Siglar-Najjar syndrome and Gilbert syndrome. Number two, acquired defect by drug or viral hepatitis or cirrhosis. Number three, neonatal jaundice, as glucosamine transferase is low at birth. So, at birth, baby may develop neonatal jaundice due to lack of glucosamine transferase. Then about predominantly conjugate hyperbilirubinemia due to conjugated bilirubin. Number A, impaired intrahepatic excretion of bile within liver and outside liver. Impaired intrahepatic excretion of bile, it is within the liver. The cause of it, number one, hepatocellular damage due to drug-induced hepatitis, viral hepatitis. Number two, hereditary disorder, Duven jaundice syndrome, Rotor syndrome. Number three, oral